Hi everyone. Today we will start by understanding how will be our project of neural networks and what is its structure. So I have created an UML diagram to show the structure of our network library. Here you can see all the classes and the most important methods and properties each class will have. So you may think that this is really complex, but most of the classes are really easy to do. Okay, there are a bit like 5 classes that are complex and the rest are really easy. So the core library, the core class will be the neural network. Okay, that is this class. So it will have an output layer, an input layer as we have seen, and a list of layers, okay? And this may vary depending on the topology of the network. Then we will have 3 constructors, okay? The first will have an input layer, an output layer, and a list of layers. And we will assign them to the properties. Then we will have another with the number of input neurons, the number of output neurons, and the initializers, okay? And also the activation we want to have in the output layer. And then the error function. Okay, then we will have the 4 methods that we saw that are really important in the training algorithm, that are the initialize, the feedforward, the backpropagation, and the method adjust that will update the weights and bias with the gradient descent algorithm. Then we will have also the method calculate error when we do the feedforward, and then we'll have both most important methods that we will be using, that will be the train, that will have a data set, the number of epochs, the number of mini batches, and an optimizer. Okay? And it will have a network task that is a class in charge of monitoring our network. And then we will have the method add layer to add a layer in the list. Okay, this is the class we will be using outside of the network library to create projects. Then we have seen that we have a list of layers. Okay, the output layer, input layer, and the layer will extend of layer. Okay, that is a class that, as you will see here, it has an input tensor that, okay, that we have seen this in previous videos what they are. Okay, every data we want to have in the network will be a tensor. So we'll have an input of the layer, the output, okay, that when we process the input, we will have the output, and the processing will be different of each layer. And this will be also a tensor. And then we will have the shape of the output. Okay, then we have the 3 most important methods in a layer, that is the initialize, the feedforward, and the backpropagation. Okay, but we have a problem. Okay, also sorry, we have these 2 methods, that is to pass a layer as a JSON file, okay, to save our work, and to print to convert into a string. Then we will have another class that will be a child of the layer. Okay, this is the super class of learning layer. This everything is object oriented, so to structure grade our project is very important that we have everything like organized. So then we will have a learning layer that will extend from layer, and this will have a tensor of weights, a tensor of bias, the gradient, that are the derivatives of the error with respect to each weight, and the same for the bias. and then we'll have some protected values that will be the weights initializer for the learning layer, the bias initializer, and the error signal. Okay, that we have seen this in the backpropagation video. Okay, this will have the same methods as the layer. Okay, so sorry, it will have an initializer, a constructor that will have as parameters the initializer of the weights and biases, and then we'll have the same methods as in layer, that just initialize, feedforward, and backpropagation. Sorry, the adjust is only for the learning layer, not every layer, okay? Because we will adjust only when we have weights and biases. Okay, so this method is only for the learning layer. And then we'll have also to JSON, to string, and we'll have these three methods to update the gradient depending on the iteration we are currently in each mini batch. So now we will start to define each layer. So we have the activation layer, okay, that will have an activation function, then initialize, feedforward, and backpropagation, and to JSON, okay? Everything here is because it will extend from layer, okay? So it will have that parameters, okay, that we will overwrite, okay? Also, we have an input layer that will be simple. It will have these methods. All of these we will be implementing in Java with the math calculation we do in the theory. And we'll have the output layer, okay? These three will be extending from layer. The output layer, another thing, it will have a layer that will be inside it, and it could be an activation layer, a hidden layer, or whatever. Then we'll have the hidden layer that will extend from the learning layer because it will have weights and biases, and then we'll have the fully connected layer. Okay, this layer will have the activation layer. Okay, we'll have inside the activation layer that we have seen here, okay, and also a hidden layer, so it will combine both, okay, and this will have for like the same values because it extends from learning layer. Okay, now we will start by understanding how will be our activation function. Okay, it will have a method called activate and the derivative for the backpropagation. Okay, and here we will specific classes that will be our activation functions, that will be the logistic, the ReLU, and the softmax, that are the most important, but we will can implement also a lot of them like the hyperbolic tant and whatever. Also, we will have an initializer that we have seen here in the learning layer, that we will have the most important, the random and the zeros. The random could be a normal distribution, or it could be completely random, okay? But we will see it when we implement them, okay? And then we will have the dataset class that will have a data element and a list of data elements, and each data element will have the input and the desired tensor. And here we'll have, for example, the class means that will extend it will have a data set, okay, and it will have a method called read data, okay, that will be inherited from the loader class that will have read data and unfinish. Okay, one thing that I haven't said is that everything here will be implemented with threads, okay, to improve the optimization and have different and separate tasks that don't interfere from the others. Okay, okay, so now the other thing that we have we haven't seen is that we have the class optimizer, that we have the learning rate, and then the kind, and here we can specialize different other classes and optimization algorithms like the momentum or Adam or whatever. And then another thing is that I have said a little bit, we have a network class that will be a thread, okay, a runnable, and here it will have also a network monitor that will be in charge of updating some important things if we want in a program that has a neural network to track these different variables. So this is the tracker of our project, okay? I haven't put the tensor and some useless library classes that we will also be having, but this is a general idea that you need to have when we implement the network library. So see you in the next video, and we will implement everything that we have seen here.